All right, let's look at the homework 10.4, problem number 8. All right, so we want to find the arc length of this given polar curve. All right, so let's do that. All right, so we need to find, let's see, derivative here. So r prime is going to be equal to 2 theta. All right, then if you want to find the arc length element, this is going to be square root of r squared, which is going to be theta to the fourth power, plus r prime squared would be 4 theta squared. Right? Then d theta, so there's d theta there. Right? So one thing I can do is I'm going to pull out theta squared from here. So square root of theta squared would be just theta. And with the absolute value sign, but theta is not negative, so we don't have to worry about that. Then you have a square root of, theta squared plus 4. And d theta, right? So you want to find the arc length. L is going to be integral from 0 to 3 pi over 4. Then theta square root of theta squared plus 4 d theta. All right. Then we can probably use a substitution here. We're going to let u be theta squared plus 4. All right. Then you can take the derivative of u with respect to theta. That's going to give us 2 theta. And take the reciprocal of both sides. And then we get 1 over 2 theta. Then we can multiply through by du to isolate d theta, which is going to be du over 2 theta. Right, so we got that, and also lower limit and upper limit, right? When theta is going from 0 to 3 pi over 4, then u is going to be, put 0 in there, so it's a 4, 2, right? Square that, so it's going to be 9 pi squared over 16 plus 4. All right, so this is going to be integral from 4 to 9 pi squared over 16 plus 4. All right, and I'm going to leave theta, and this is going to be square root of u, so I'm going to write it as u to the 1 half. D theta is equivalent to du over 2 theta. All right. So we can cancel theta on top and theta on the bottom. We can probably put 1 half outside. All right, then what you get is going to be, all right, so 1 half is outside. Antiderivative of u to the 1 half power would be u to the 3 halves power. Divide by 3 halves is equivalent to multiply by 2 thirds. All right. Then you're going from 4 to 9 pi squared over 16 plus 4. All right, then we can just cancel 2 on top and 2 on the bottom. And then we can bring out the 1/3. So I'm going to bring out the 1/3 outside. Then plug in. This guy here. So you're going to have, let's see, so you have a 9 pi squared over 16 and plus 4 and raise it to the 3 halves power, right? And minus, and put 4 in there, so it's going to be 4, square root of 4 is 2, cube that, so it's going to be 8. Right? So we got that. All right. It doesn't look pretty, but that should do it, right? So you have, right? So this is going to be, let's see, we got the 1/3, right? Then we have, right, let's see, 9π² over 16 plus 4 raise it to the 3/2 power minus 8, right? So that's the arc length. All right, let's double check. Submit for testing. All right, it came back and looks like we got this one correctly, even though it's not very pretty. All right, that's it. I hope that this was clear.